Hello, I'm PJ De Troia from IT ADI team, and welcome back on the ITSM Leaders Dashboard webcast. For those of you who are new to this topic or are discovering the ITSM report with this video, please first watch the previous webcast we released in May. You'll find the link in the description of this post. Because in today's video, I won't explain the generalities on the dashboard, nor will go through all pages, but I will focus on the latest changes we brought on past weeks, and I will try to keep this as short as possible. So without further ado, let's jump into it. And the first improvement that you might already have noticed is this brand new welcome page named Summary Delta Tiles, which will show you at a glance all the key measures of the report. So you don't need to open each page to see your results. I know this was expected by many of you to have such a summary page, so here it is. But not only this page presents you all the measures at once, it also allows you to perform dynamic delta analysis. Let me show you how. On the header, you can specify the two periods you want to compare. So by default, we show months minus two and last months. So currently comparing April and May. But you can select amongst numerous options. For example, if you prefer to compare periods of same duration, you can use this rolling over 30 days choices. Let's grab these minus 60 days to minus 30 days as period one. And as period two, let's pick up the last 30 days. So you can see that all the tiles dynamically recalculate the results and the delta for these two periods. You can also compare last year versus this year, year to date or year to month periods. And we also put some weekly periods, such as week minus two or last week versus current week. That can be interesting to run some wars. So on the tiles, you'll see the trend between these two periods, and thanks to the color coding, you can quickly spot if this trend is positive or a negative result. Now, what if you want to deep dive and understand precisely where the delta is coming from for a certain measure? Of course, you can go to the detail page dedicated to this KPI. For example, let's go on all incidents. We see an increase between May and June, even if June is not yet finished, but we can't really see from here what composes this delta. But the new welcome page can. So let me quickly show you how to use it. First, let's select last month as period one and current month as period two. So you can notice we have here exactly the same figures that what we were seeing in the dedicated page, all incidents. Now let's select on the top right the measure total count of failure incidents that we want to investigate. Then this sweet chart at the bottom will distribute this overall delta figure by here the location where we can now identify that the overall increase of 832 incidents is coming first from M&A zone. Here the delta by the ages parent stream, and finally here by the product taxonomy. For each of these charts, you have access to the entire hierarchy, which will allow you to drill down from top to lowest dimensions. So let's, for example, focus on this increase of 305 incidents on Workforce 360. Ensure the drill down mode is on, then click on it, and you'll see from which streams this increase comes. By the way, you can notice that once you drill down, the entire page has been recalculated to focus on Workforce 360. You can even go deeper and display the delta at the AG level. Don't forget to drill up back to the top level so that you remove the filter we just set. And you can also view this delta from the product taxonomy perspective. For example, here we see an increase by 153 incidents on marketing, sales, and e-business products. And we can drill down within MSC product groups to highlight that behind this increase, e-commerce and e-content in fact decreased their failures by 71. You can here drill down to product till business application. We truly believe that this page will actually ease some of your analyses and potentially some of your operational reviews. So feel free to start using it and let us know your thoughts, if you like the concept or if you have any issue or proposal, send us your comments. Now, let's move on to the other key change for this month. The assignment history page has been enhanced to include collaborations. Just as a reminder, in ServiceNow, an incident has an assignment group, but the agent can also add some ages as collaboration groups. We were not yet using this information, and we received a request to have the possibility to count and analyze these collaborations. So now the page has been renamed Assignment and Collaborations Overview, and by this filter named Assignment Collaboration Type, you can now choose to focus only on the primary assignments, which was the only behavior till this change, or include collaborations, or even focus only on collaborations. As you can see with this last option, these two charts on the bottom and this top total wrong assignments count are blank. This is normal since there is no wrong collaboration, this flag being only available when you modify the primary AG, not when you set or remove a collaboration group. On the request from some users who wanted to deeply investigate the assignments history for their AGs, we also added a list view of all assignments and now also all collaborations in this new page named Assignment and Collaboration List. So you understood that for one single incident, you might see here several rows which correspond to each assignment or collaboration on this incident with the start and end dates plus some other interesting information. This list may also be very interesting, for example, when you filter on one specific AG to list all the incidents on which this group worked on, both as a primary AG or just as a collaborating AG, because you also have in this page the choice to include or not the collaborations. When filtering on one incident without going to ServiceNow, this detailed list can quickly give you the summary of the history of which group contributed to this particular incident. Note there is no change on the next page, the Sankey diagram, which still only focuses on the primary assignments, since this measure is explicitly based on the flow between preceding AG and next AG. And there is no such flow for collaborations, where the groups are picked up in whatever order. And as you could see when I was sharing the ServiceNow screen just before, we can have several collaborating groups at the same time. On this same topic, I'm quite excited to announce that we are working on a POC using Celonis to offer you highly detailed process mining of our ServiceNow ITSM data, where you'll see the different paths the incidents take through the different AGs, but also the impact on the throughput time, multi-op and conformance analysis, which should allow ITSM specialists to find the blocking points and where they can gain efficiency and reduce the time to resolution, etc., etc. Believe me, this is very impressive and promising, and I'll try soon to record an introduction video on this. Once done, be sure I add the link in the comments below, so stay tuned. Back on the dashboard, let's progress on the third key change, which is quite a big change. Even if not that visible, it relates to the location dimensions that we are using in numerous charts in the dashboard. Remember, we used to derive the geographical dimensions of the incidents from their end-to-end owner group, usually the service desk who first logged the incident. But in many cases, this was not showing the reality of the actual incident location. Example here, the Brazilian service desk is the end-to-end owner group of this incident for user located in Chile. So typically this one was previously showed under Market Brazil and not Chile. So we are now using the incidents location, which by default is populated by the colors location. We obviously also align the filters with this new logic that are available as global filters for all pages. And note, we still kept the end-to-end owner group filter for users who potentially still want to narrow the analysis for one or several end-to-end owner groups. But please now keep in mind that all these geographical charts that I'm showing now are using the incidence location and no more the end-to-end owner group location. We also took the opportunity to make these geographical analyses available for the other objects we are showing on the All Tickets page, the catalog task and the requested items. Let me just remove the monitoring alerts for which there is generally no location set. So we managed to build this bottom left chart, which was not yet available on this page. And for this, we are in fact following the same logic, that is to derive the zone, the region, and the market from the requester's location. Moving on, next improvement, we introduced a new measure that was awaited by many of you, the vendor resolution ratio, which simply calculates the percentage of tickets closed by AGs that are marked as is vendor, divided by the total number of tickets. So this measure works for incidents and catalog tasks, and the design of this page is quite similar to the customer satisfaction page, showing in the header the overall count of tickets closed by vendors and the overall ratio. Here you see the ratio for incidents and for catalog tasks, then the results distributed by the AG streams, and here by the product stream, product group, etc. This one being only available for products, since we still don't have a link between catalog tasks and products in ServiceNow. Here is the monthly trend, or even weekly if you activate the drill down, and finally the count of tickets closed by each vendor and a detailed list of these tickets with the direct link to ServiceNow if you want to access all the info on a specific ticket. By the way, we also took the opportunity to review and correct this is vendor flag, since with the introduction of this measure, we quickly identified that this was not populated for numerous AGs in ServiceNow. Now this has been massively rectified thanks to the support of ServiceNow Architect. Similarly, as you might know, we are continuously running master data reviews and cleansing exercises, especially on the AG to stream and parent stream mapping. This has improved a lot since last release. And we continue to perform some reviews and adjustments thanks to the coordination of the PSOMs within their stream. Finally, the fifth and last key change this month is an update on the P1 incidents logic. In addition to the highest priority that the incident reached in his lifetime and the valid critical incident flag, we now also check that the wrong priority flag is not ticked. So this incident, for example, is no more displayed as a P1, but is still being displayed as a critical incident. Here is the change of the logic explained with the matrix of P1 and critical incidents conditions. So in summary, these tickets where a valid critical incident is set to true, highest priority is P1, and wrong priority is yes, were previously considered as a P1 and are now only considered as critical incident. For now, this just removed one incident, the one I just showed you. But it's important that everyone understands the conditions that are applied behind this P1 and critical incidents. Remember that all these logics, the filters we are using for each page and each measure, are explained in the knowledge article you can access directly from the footer. This KB has also been updated very recently to align with the latest changes developed in the dashboard. So the new pages introduced this month, such as the summary tiles, the vendor resolution ratio, etc., are there. So please do not hesitate to refer to it when you have any doubt. So that were the main changes on the ITLT dashboard for June. There were also some more minor updates we brought to answer some announcements raised by the end user. So for example, we added some new columns in the detail list. Some new filters were also made available, such as the feature set, the feature, the resolution code. And we also added new vendors under the AG vendor name options. So these are less visible changes, but still, I hope this actually simplifies the work for some of you. And that's it for this month. Remember that if you have any announcement to propose, please first contact your PSOM, since all of this is built, decided, and arbitrated in close collaboration with the PSOM community and with Workforce 360, especially Daniel Hoffman and Osvaldo Santos. Again, thank you for this teamwork and your support and your trust. Still, for all end users, should you have any issue or announcement proposal, please follow the support model detailed by Philippe Favre in the link you can find in the description. We are reviewing all announcements on a weekly basis, every Thursday, with Workforce 360 and the owners of the IT Performance app and the ITSM dashboard, and the development team. Talking about the team, as usual, a big, big thanks to my colleague from ADI Internal Analytics team, Netra, Naga, Jacob, Pavan, and last but not least, our team leader, Pravin. Thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned and stay safe, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.